Good morning, guys. For this week's safety video, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about something that's pretty near and dear to my heart, complacency. Throughout all my time and all my endeavors, you know, from the military to firefighter, medical first responder, into construction, and then now into the safety field, I've seen a lot of very good people get injured or killed that didn't need to be, and that's mostly due to complacency or complacency related. So complacency is defined as self-satisfaction, especially when accompanied by unawareness of actual dangers or deficiencies. It's also defined as an instance of usually unaware or uninformed self-satisfaction. One of the things I really like to attribute it to is, let's take the extra second, take a step back, actually analyze the situation, the work that you're doing, and just have a conversation with somebody and bounce it off another source. Stop and ask that guy in the boom lift with you, hey, you know, check me out, did I tie off? Get into a habit of just looking at each other if you and a partner are in a boom lift. If you're setting concrete, make sure you guys talk about different situations, different scenarios, and everything that you can be doing in order to avoid somebody getting hurt due to complacency. One thing I really like to do is pull everybody together, have that group meeting before somebody gets hurt. Now, here in the very recent past, we had one of our own members take a very small, non-injuring fall due to that same thing of complacency. Instead of, you know, stopping, looking at the actions, he put his foot out on a slick piece of steel, ended up sliding a little bit, took a tumble. Now, thankfully, it wasn't a much farther fall, and thankfully that it was a slow enough fall to where nobody got injured, and the only bit of damage was to the harness itself. So all the equipment did. Now, they did a good job inspecting everything, making sure everything was set up prior to, just in case something like that happened. But once we actually took a step back and had a conversation, we identified three or four different ways in which they could have done something a little bit differently that could have avoided that from happening in the first place. So please continue to remember that. Have your meetings, have your briefs, take your time, have the conversations, and by all means, let's be as safe as possible. That's it for this week's video. Thank you. Have a great week.